You are welcome back. We are going in our part two. We are continuing for where we stop. As we say, identify yourself who you are. Which clan, tribe, nation are you from? What are your culture? What are your tradition? There's nothing wrong with your tradition. Your tradition and your identity. A human without culture and tradition, they are lost souls. And then many people try to make a separate relationship or try to separate humanity and spirituality. How do you separate them when they're still in coalition? Because when you are alive, it simply means you are in coalition with humanity and spirituality. We say we are three in one. Spirit, soul, and body. So the three are in coalition. And the mediator is the soul. You cannot separate the two as long as you're still alive because they are in coalition. Then from there, you need to practice both coalition members' requirement in order for your soul to enjoy and both of you to make what you are as a human successful. How I'm explaining. As a body, you need to bathe, you need to eat, you need to dress up. You need to drink, you need to breathe. If you are feeding your body, what are you feeding your spirit with? Because your spirit as well got a requirement for its survival as a spiritual being. And for it to be able to provide. Your spirit is the first mediator between you and the higher spirit, which you might call God, which you might call creator, which you might call whomever you can call. But now, when your spirit becomes underfitted, you do not make provision for your spiritual person, but you only provide for the human one. There's imbalance. How? Let's go now in simple words. We take an example. You are a business leader, a political leader, a civil society, a religious leader. At the position of leadership, you are dealing with different spirits. You are dealing with disparate souls and body. Each individual person that you're dealing with, there are three forces. Some of them are enlightened, some of them are not enlightened. So in those events, what one do? In those kind of events, one need to be prepared in both three levels. And the only way to be prepared in both three levels is when the two in coalition are together. You do not run a successful business when you sleep at the same time as everyone, you wake up at the same time as everyone, you do what everyone is doing. You don't even know who was successful in your tribe, in your family. And as the rest, what they've done. You do not have time to honor your own ancestors. You do not have time to honor your God. You take money, you hide in the bank. You don't pray. You are hiding. I don't say take your money to your church. I don't say write it in the newspaper. But there are rituals when you are doing business, when you are doing, you are running a religious organization, when you are running in a political organization, or when you are working as an employee, as an administrator, whatever level you are in society, there are rituals, there are prayers that when they are done, your things will be well. Sometimes you notice there are people around you, people in your class, in social class, who are always be favored and successful because they respect the principles. Those principles, they are simple. I always advise those in business, for example, those in politics, those in executives, to a spiritual advisor the same way you got a lawyer, the same way you've got a doctor, the same way you've got different service accountant. The reason being why? When you are dealing with people from different culture, you don't know their background. And what will happen? You might be misled by somebody's behavior, thinking they are friendly when they are not. So, for example, when in business, you need to use a green candle for your financial prayers. You need to know how to attract clients. Not you go to the shop and just buy something because they tell you, for example, that sage can clean the house. You enter in the shop, you just buy sage and clean the house. Are you sure that in your culture they clean houses with sage? It's true, sage cleans. But is it applicable to your specific culture? They tell you that a green candle is bringing money. It's true. But it's also applicable to your culture. Is it tradition from where you originate that it happened like that? Do you have enough knowledge? And if you don't, you need a spiritual advisor. Somebody who is dedicated to those kind of work. Somebody who understands it. If you got knowledge, you need also advices and support. Then you join platform like ours and learn. There are spiritual masters, archangels. I'm going to give the example of Master Hilarion. I hope many of you know. Is there a 50 rate for the financial benefit? Is the reincarnation of Paul of the Bible? Those in business, they can benefit from his raise and cover their financial stability. The archangel, like Abu Dhansia, Archangel Raphael, they are not God and goddess. He depends on your faith. I'm open to teach you. I'm open to advise you. I'm open to guide you. I might not be able to give the details of all the rituals in this platform. Subscribe, support, let's grow so that we can be able to organize Zoom meetings. Through Zoom meetings, I'll be teaching you with the altar build how to do certain rituals. When you're a political leader, when you are a religious leader, when you're a businessman, when you are an employee, you understand, when you are not employed, when you are still studying, when you are still growing. Spirituality, there's nothing evil inside. It's all about you. If you still live in the ignorance that you are a spiritual being, you just think you are human, that is your problem. But today I come to tell you what. Because it's what keeps you single, is what keeps you without a job, is what keeps you broke, is what keeps you worried and sick, stressed, because you are making an effort yourself to refuse to accept that besides you being a human with a desire, need, You are also a spiritual being with desire and need at a spiritual level. And you are maybe ignorant of those desires today. Start in my teaching. Step by step, you're going to learn. Still your servant, spiritual master. I hope you enjoyed the show. I hope you're going to send your comments, advice, remark, and request. Don't forget to like and subscribe to encourage us to provide the show. Have a blessed evening. Let's meet in part 3 now for the last of this. Thank you.